In this overview, for service administrators, we'll show you the highlights of using the EPM Automate Replay command. EPM Automate is a command line utility that you can install on client machines. The replay command lets you simulate the user experience in a test environment under heavy load to evaluate performance before migrating the environment to production. This lets you ensure that the load or other activities performed in SmartView won't negatively impact the user experience during concurrent activity. You can remotely perform and automate common administrative tasks such as loading, extracting, backing up, restoring, and using jobs to launch business rules or to refresh the database. You can use the replay command with the following, which supports SmartView: planning, financial consolidation and close, narrative reporting, profitability and cost management, sales planning, strategic workforce planning, and tax reporting. You'll perform these basic tasks to use the replay command. Install and launch Telerik Fiddler, a free tool. Making sure you're recording in Fiddler, open SmartView and perform the activities you want to replay and test on the test environment. Export the Fiddler files to HAR format. Create multiple HAR files to simulate a heavy load. Create a replay CSV file that lists the credentials and the names of the HAR files you created. Launch EPM Automate and run the replay command using the replay CSV file, and then review the activity report to identify any issues. Let's explore how to use the replay command with a sample planning application. To get started, install EPM Automate and then Fiddler. Then identify the forms or activities that require major processing. This could include forms with lots of data or that involve complex calculations. Use Fiddler to track the activities that you'll perform in SmartView, being sure that Fiddler is configured to intercept HTTPS traffic. In SmartView, run the activities you want to replay and test to ensure good performance. Fiddler records these processes and captures them as session files. Next, export the session files to an HTTP archive or HAR format. In a text editor or a string replacement program, open the HAR file and modify the values of the POV, user-defined variables, substitution variables, and so on to simulate another user. Each change must be recorded in its own file. For example, to test a load of 100 users, create 100 HAR files. This replicates multiple SmartView sessions. In Microsoft Excel, create a worksheet that lists the user credentials and the HAR files to run. Each row contains the username and a password to simulate multiple simultaneous user sessions. Save the worksheet as a CSV file. Next, launch and log in to EPM Automate and run the replay command. Using the replay CSV file, EPM Automate runs each row in the replay file in parallel to simulate concurrent users. To make the simulation even more realistic, you can use the lag time parameter to set the number of seconds that the command waits before running each HAR file in the replay file. After the replay finishes, review the activity report to identify potential issues. In this overview, we showed you the highlights of using the EPM Automate replay command. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.